picked up literally by strip club stalker. In 2003, I was working as a stripper in the Phoenix area. I've been dancing for almost a year, and still getting the hang of how to get the most money from a regular with the least amount of cleanliness. I was working off and on at four different clubs. I'll be calling them Club 1, 2, 3, and 4 for reference. Alternating day shifts and night shifts depending on money. One night shift, this skinny, straggly looking guy comes into Club 1 and hones in me right away. From the way he's bouncing and twitching in his seat, it's clear even in the strip club lighting, he's a meth addict and higher than my heels. No biggie, I was raised by meth addicts. As long as he is happy, this shouldn't be too hard, it should be easy money. We go to VIP chat, I relieve him of his paycheck, and he goes on his way. The next night he comes back again and is looking for me. I get his name, Steve, tell him my name, Tori, my fake backstory, and head back to VIP again. He tells me he's a truck driver and is only in town for a few days a month. We have a perfectly nice, if not jittery time, no red flags. Everyone goes home happy, or in his case, sexually frustrated. Repeat the next night, then I don't see him for a month. This continues for about 4 months. He starts bringing in the finest gas station meth addict to prove gifts when he comes in to see me. By this point, he's also serenading me half the time I'm dancing for him. His favorite was Picture by Kid Rock and Sheryl Crow. He sang it despite whatever song was playing. Thankfully, I spent a lot of my time with my back to him, and my ass doesn't have ears, so I can only hear snippets of his impassioned baritone. The singing was creepy, not just because it's on repeat. He's now gesturing specific lyrics at me. The longer he sings, the more grabby he's getting. Not anywhere illegal, but grabbing my face to force me to stare back at him, intertwining our fingers to hold hands, pressing my hand to his heart, trying to press his hands to mine. By the end of this month visit, he asked me to move in with him. He tells me that he just wants to know I'm at his house all the time. Of course, he also envisions himself as a typical customer in shining armor. He's telling me he wants to save me, take me away from all this. I decide to be a little more honest with him and explain I have a girlfriend and am not interested in men, not interested in him, and that I'm happy living where I am. He tells me he'll let me keep my girlfriend. All he needs to do is to go down on me 3 days a month he's in town. I shut him down again. He starts begging me to think about it and will come help me move in with him when he gets back next month. After this, I tell my manager to ban him. Unfortunately, without a picture of him on hand at all times, that's pretty much impossible. I had settled for alerting the security, bartender, and manager to give me a warning if he comes in again asking for me. When this time of the month comes around, I switch to a different club at 2, 3, and 4 to avoid him. When I go back to Club 1 the next week, he's left a couple of filled plastic grocery bags for me. They're full of notes scrawled on crumpled, dirty scraps of paper. Legible letters professing his love, insistence again that I move into his place, and some poorly written graphic details of what he wanted to do to my body. I was sufficiently grossed out and creeped out, and happy I dodge his monthly visit. The following month rolls around, and I ditch what has become my regular club to avoid him again. I'm working the day shift at Club 2, good money from lots of bored dudes on their lunch breaks. It's getting to the last couple hours of my shift and slow. I was on stage, not really paying attention, as I finished up my routine. I don't see him until I was heading down the stairs to get upstage. He was a few feet in front of me, waving and starts yelling, "Tori!" over and over and over. There was no way to get around him. As soon as I got to the bottom of the stairs, he grabs me in a big hug. I was still topless from being on stage and did not want him touching me. He wouldn't let go and kept grabbing handfuls of my hair and smelling it. I pushed away from him and started to tell him that my shift is over and that was my last stage and I'm headed home. He looks frustrated and upset and says he just wants to hang out with me before he has to leave town tonight. I tell him he'll have to pay for me to sit with him, whether I'm dancing or not, and he agrees. I go and give the bartender and security a heads up that he's my very creepy stalker guy, then go back to taking his money and attempting to placate him. Instead of having him actually dance for him, he has me straddle him topless while we talk, not as unusual as it sounds, plus a nice break for me. He was unusually shaky and jumpy this time, so I resorted to making him sit on his hands. He proceeds to tell me how he went to multiple clubs looking for me this month, how he asked various clubs if his girlfriend, Tori, was there. He tells me he has his house all cleaned up and ready for me to move into. I remind him again that I am not moving in with him. He excitedly replies, "Well, you never know." I again remind him of my girlfriend. Also, I was making plans to move to Canada with. He says he's in love with me, and that our whole lives are about to change now that we found each other. Between all this jilted conversation, he's saying lines from Picture again, and prodding me to sing along with him, like some fucked up romantic duet. Finally, despite the money, I decide he's just being way too crazy this time, and it's really creeping me out. I tell him I'm done with my shift, and I really need to get home. Before I can get off him, he suddenly wraps his arms around my waist, picks me up, and starts running towards a hallway that leads to the exit. I'm still fucking topless, wrapped around this crazy, out skinny, straggly, dirty trucker while trying to flag down the bartender, DJ, anyone, because security wasn't there all of a sudden. He made it to the hallway, and about 10 feet from the door, when the absolutely massive security guard stepped back inside from walking a girl to her car. Steve tries to dart around him, and I'm reaching for security, while Steve tries to pull me away from security and get to the door. The brick wall of a security guard manages to plant himself in front of us and pulls me off of him before Steve can try anything else. He insists he was just joking, and that he was just trying to tell me goodbye. I bolted out of there and into the dressing room while he was still yelling for me to come say goodbye to him, as security practically carried his bony ass outside. Thankfully, he was banned this time. I decided to take a vacation with my girlfriend for a couple months after that, just in case he tried to show up in the parking lot of the club to stuff me in his trunk. He continued to call the club looking for me while I was gone. They lied and said I quit working there. So, crazy, meth, addict trucker, let's never meet again unless it's your remaining teeth and my baseball bat. Creepy older lady in the strip club. I work as a dancer at a pretty safe club. There are cameras everywhere being monitored heavily. The bouncers have eyes like hawks, and they walk you to your car at the end of the night. I might have dealt with some douchebags, but never once have I felt unsafe until this lady came in one Wednesday night. We were about an hour from closing, and we were all ready to go home, since it had been slow all night and we were tired. This awesome lesbian couple walked in from the club next door and were tipping us pretty well. We were stoked that we had paying customers after an hour or two of nothing. Shortly after one of my last stage sets for the evening, this older lady had made her way into our club, and I could tell the couple immediately got uncomfortable. I asked what was wrong, and they said she followed them from the club next door. She was wearing somewhat baggy mom clothes, had messy hair, what I think was ginger or strawberry blonde, not really sure. A long thin neck and small round head, and dark beady eyes. Something immediately seemed off about her. This lady was mad that the couple had left her alone in there, and the couple promptly got up and left, understandably not wanting to give her another chance to interact with them. She kept staring at me with this unsettling look, and she sat at my stage, saying she wasn't going to be here all night by herself, and not giving me a single dollar. She kept saying that I was so pretty, like a Barbie doll, making me super uncomfortable. It felt like I was being fetishized, and I mean, in a really scary, creepy, I wanna wear your skin kind of way. We were all trying to hide from her in the dressing room, unless we had to go on stage, and she would literally be standing right by the door, almost waiting for us to come out of there. When it was time for us to close, I felt relieved and relaxed. She was finally gone, and of course, as I'm leaving with a bouncer to go to my car, she's sitting right on the curb next to the entrance. She immediately gets up as soon as I walk out the door and tries to talk to us, and the bouncer is really trying hard to make space between the two of us. He starts walking me to the car, and she actually tried to follow us to my car. The bouncer said he had no time for her bullshit, made her go back on the curb, and I was thankfully able to get to my car safe and sound. I sped off feeling deeply unsettled. I had seen her two other times in my club, though she stayed far away from me for the most part. She was still a bit of a nuisance, because she would be all over our male customers, trying to talk to them and stealing the attention away from us. A bouncer finally kicked her out for good, after she kept trying to get her to leave us alone while we were talking. Haven't seen her since, and really hope it doesn't happen again. I worry this might seem like overreacting, but I was definitely shaken up by the first interaction with this woman. And, as a dancer, you never know what people are truly intending for you, or what you're perceived as feeling less than, or people thinking it's okay to say or do awful things to you just because of your occupation, I guess. I can only imagine what FSSW have to deal with what I imagine is on a more regular basis. So I was super freaked out, and I just wanted to share.